Dear learners and listeners, welcome to NIS Studio. I am Dr. Shweta and today we would be talking about our next lesson, which is career development, and it is lesson number 27 in your senior secondary psychology self-learning material. Put your career in top gear for those who want to add a new dimension to their career. Join this institution. NIIT offers you excellent career opportunities. Attention students, the Times of India presents a comprehensive section on educational and career opportunities. You might have come across many such advertisements in newspapers, magazines, handbills, etc. Does the word career ring a bell in your mind? What exactly is career or career building? This program will help you understand the concept of career. It will also help you in developing your career in a more systematic way, because we would be talking about that what steps need to be taken while planning a career. Before we begin with this program, we must know that what are the objectives of today's program. So, at the end of this program, you will be able to state the meaning and stages of career development. You would also be able to explain the various aspects of career development, describe how one can plan one's career, explain the concept of continuing education and in-service training, and you would also be able to describe the conditions under which career adjustment becomes necessary. At last, we would be describing the concept of self-employment. Let's begin with today's program. First of all, we must know that what is the meaning of a career. The term career in career development refers to all activities which a person does in his or her lifetime. These activities include personal, occupational and social life of the person. Thus, career refers to the life pattern of a person. Development is the modification of behavior as a result of growth and learning. It normally involves a progressive change. Thus, we can say that career development means the overall development in the lifestyle of a person, the experiences that are contributing as a whole to the formation of identity, that includes the life experiences which a person has, the education that the person acquires, the various career choices that a person makes and that in return helps in career development. The on-the-job training that a person gets while on the job or while doing certain job, the level of professional achievement, and lastly, the degree of satisfaction which one acquires in a particular job. Now, the question arises, how the lifestyle of a person develops? Obviously, vocation plays an important role in the lifestyle of a person, and vocational development is the basis of career development. For example, if a person gets promoted to executive cadre from non-executive cadre, he or she will get more facilities from the organization, like higher salaries, bigger accommodations, etc. The lifestyle of a person automatically changes. Promotion is part of vocational development, but it is also bringing about a change in person's social and personal life also. Once we have understood the meaning of career and the various stages that contributes to the career development, we should know that what are the life stages and how vocational development is related to different life stages. Concept of life stages and stages of vocational development will give greater insight into the understanding of career development. Generally, there are 5 life stages. Number 1, the growth stage. Number 2, the exploratory stage. Number 3, the establishment stage. Number 4, the maintenance stage. And last, which is number 5, is the decline stage. Let us understand about these stages in greater detail. As you can see from the table, first is the growth stage. A growth stage comprises the stage from conception to about the age of 14. It is preparatory stage during which a child develops basic skills. Then comes the exploratory stage, which is between 15 to 25 years of age, and during this stage a person tends to think and understand about self, his role in becoming an adult, finding a life partner, occupation and place in the community. The next stage is the establishment stage, which ranges from 25 to 45 years of age. In this stage, one establishes himself or herself and gains some occupational identity. Then the next stage which comes is the maintenance stage, which means that this stage covers the years of life between 45 to 58 years. During this stage, a person maintains his establishment. That is, whatever he has acquired, whatever position he has acquired, he tries to establish and maintain that position. The last stage is the decline stage. As we all know, people usually get retired at the age of 58 or 60 years. What happens at this stage? Person is not able to keep up well, his or her health declines, he is not able to take up all the responsibilities of the family as well. So at this age, people take retirement. But nowadays, a trend has been seen where lot of people are working after their retirement also. Once we have understood that what are the various stages of life and how they relate to our career development, we must know that what are the different stages of vocational development. The different stages of vocational development may be described as follows. Number one is the early exploration stage. What is early exploration stage? Lot of people who are now in job must have realized that at some point of time when they join the first job, that can be their part-time or a temporary job. That means that is the early exploration stage of the vocational development. Then comes the exploration and trial stage. What happens in this exploration and trial stage? When we are in a job and once we start working in that job, then we try to explore more and more avenues and in the end, we try to settle in a job as per our liking. This stage is also called the floundering stage. After the exploration stage, that means once we have explored the various avenues that were available with us during the early stages of choosing a vocation, then comes the establishment and maintenance stage. As the name suggests, establishment and maintenance means that once you have acquired a job, now you try to establish yourself in that job and maintain a position that you have acquired in your work. And last stage, as we mentioned in the life stages also, is the decline stage. So here in the vocational development stage, it is the retirement stage. And we already discussed in the retirement stage, the person tends to narrow down his or her responsibilities. Depending upon the capability of the person, he or she may either leave the job or shift to a job with lesser responsibility. The stages of career development are, in fact, the life stages combined with the stages of vocational development. Now, these were some stages of our life and how they were related to the vocational development. Once we have understood about all these stages, we must know that what is career planning and what steps should we take in mind while deciding a particular career. So, modern age is an age of planning. Even for small things like going to a movie or picnic, we have to plan. Career building is a crucial task in one's life. So, one is out to prepare a good career plan. As we just discussed, career is the overall lifestyle of a person. Career plan includes many things like planning for a personal life, planning for a social life, vocational life. These three aspects of career planning are interlinked and influence each other. Let us understand these concepts one by one. Planning of personal life. It involves planning about when to get married, what type of a person would you like to get married to, when to have children, what sort of life you want to give to your spouse and children, and many other things specifically important to you. You might have seen people who decide the person to get married according to their career. If somebody is a teacher, for example, he or she would like to marry a person who is in the same profession. People tend to have children only when they feel that they have established in their careers. This is the general trend that is seen today in most younger adults. So, this indicates that planning of a personal life is also linked to planning of the career. Then comes the planning of social life. It involves planning of lifestyle that you would want to have, the society in which you would want to move in, and the assets which you would want to acquire, etc. Social life of a person is influenced by personal and vocational life of a person. For example, if somebody is at a higher position, he or she would always want to have a big car or a big house because that shows the lifestyle which one person is having. Lastly come the planning of vocational life. It is a long process of getting ready to choose or continue to make choices from among the many occupations that are available in our society. Vocational life of a person matches the self with world of work. After knowing the self and the world of work, you need to match your qualities with the qualities that are required for each of the occupations that you know. Finally, select a vocation with which your qualities match to the maximum. It has great impact on the personal and social life of a person. In a wise vocational planning, there are three key features, namely, know thyself, know the world of work, and match the self with the world of work. First is know thyself or self-appraisal. That means before planning for a career, you must know that who are you? What are your capabilities? What are your aptitudes, abilities, your interests, your ambitions? What are the resources that you have around yourself that can help you to plan a career? And what are the limitations in your life and in your surroundings that might hinder your career planning? That is knowing yourself. The second is knowing the world of work, which means that knowledge of various occupations, the qualifications that are required for various occupations, what are the entry requirements to get a particular occupation, what are going to be the earnings, conditions of success, the advantages and disadvantages of joining a particular job, what are the promotional prospects and the compensations, etc., which one gets while in the job. That means before planning for a career, you must know that whatever career you are taking up, how that career helps you to have a better earning, how that career gives you the different promotional prospects so that you can own your skills and you can move forward in your career, how that contributes to the advantages that you would want to have in your life. Apart from this, first of all, and the most important thing which is required for the world of work or knowing the world of work is that what are the various occupations that are available in your surrounding and what are the qualifications and the entry requirement that you would have to have for choosing a particular career. Before proceeding further, let's take up the example of two people. One is Mr. Ganesh, who is a very happy taxi driver, and another is Mr. Ramesh, who is a frustrated engineer. Mr. Ganesh is happy because he chose the driving career because he was always interested in it. But Mr. Ramesh had to choose the engineering career because of the pressure of his parents and the relatives. So, this example tells us that how important it is to know ourselves before deciding on a particular career. If we do not choose our career wisely and as per our interest, we would never be happy and satisfied in whatever position we acquire in the career. Know thyself or know yourself is a key word for success in career development. It sounds very simple, but in real practice, it is quite a difficult goal. Why? Because some people feel frustrated in life because they could not understand themselves in the early stages of career development. People are not able to understand about themselves mainly because of the different reasons. First is they lack courage to be one's own self. What is that? We have seen that how young boys and girls try to imitate the heroes and heroines. That means they do not want to be what they are, what they actually are, and they do not want to be their own self, but they want to imitate others. We do not take time to know ourselves. This is another reason that we never contemplate on who we are. Even if we get time, we prefer doing some other work rather than thinking about ourselves. We misinterpret our experiences as well. For example, sometimes what happens, you get a low grade in a particular subject, and people have a tendency that they would interpret that they scored a low grade because they were not good at that subject. But here, sometimes we fail to understand that getting a low grade is not only because you were not good at that subject, but there might be other reasons. For example, you might be under stress, your health was not good, and likewise other reasons also contributes towards lower grade in a particular subject. And we tend to misinterpret this, and we would never try to choose for that subject in near future. Sometimes we do not know our desires and run after a marriage. When asked, what do you want? Most people say that they want money or anything that money can buy. If provided with lot of money, one would forward for something else. Most people move from one immediate desire to another, apparently without even realizing that what they really want, that is something which is much more basic. The most fundamental and lasting desire is to follow one's interest. So first thing one tries to realize is that there is a self. That means we are different from other individual. Each one of us is an entity, and no two individuals are always exactly the same. You are not, it is not possible that you are always alike your brother or sister in everything that you choose for your life. And everyone has one or the other ability, and everyone has the capacity to work in one or the other direction. Now, we try to understand that why it is important to know thyself before planning a particular career. But as we discussed earlier, we must know the world of work also. That means appraisal of vocations that we are choosing should be done wisely. To know the world of work is equally important for vocational planning. For different jobs, there are different types of job requirements. For example, engineers may be required to work in mines or factories, indulge in shift duties, work in hazardous conditions. They may be required to manage the subordinate staff, deal with the staff unions, etc. Similarly, journalists may be required to be on their toes always to capture the news. They should be skillful in differentiating the important and unimportant news. They should also be ready to take risks. You have to collect information about the working conditions and the job requirements of all the jobs. After a thorough study of jobs, you should select some vocations with which your qualities match. For example, match personal qualities with the qualities for selective vocations. If you choose to become a lawyer, see that you have the logical, analytical mind and a good memory, which are some of the attributes of a good lawyer. Interest, ability, aptitude and health are some of the basic criteria on the basis of which one can match the self with the world of work. Once we have understood that what is the world of work, what is career development, and how it is related to our life, we must know that what are the various steps that we must take while planning a career. So, as we have already discussed in previous slides also, we must know ourselves, which include our interest, aptitudes, abilities, skills, health, conditions, personality and priorities. We must also obtain the information about the various occupations. Sometimes what happens that people are not able to choose choose better career options for themselves because they have not explored about the various choices that they have for their career. Once you know yourself and once you have gathered information about the various occupations that you are that are around you, you should shortlist some of the occupations, for example 3 or 4, which suits your personality or your interests and aptitudes. Thorough analysis of each of the selected occupations should be done. For example, you must know that what is the nature of the work, that is, are you required to do an academic work or an administrative work, for example. Working environment is also very important. That means wherever you are working, you are required to work in the fields or you are required to sit in the office. Then the qualifications and the physical requirements that are needed for particular jobs, the understanding and the knowledge about this is also very important, because if you are not physically fit to do a particular job or if you are not qualified for a particular vocation, then you cannot have that option in with you. And last is the method of entry. The method of entry says that in order to get a particular, for example, if we talk about method of entry, if you want to become a doctor, you are required to appear in certain entrance test. Unless you appear and pass those entrance test, you are not allowed to do your MBBS. Once you are once you pass those tests, only then you can do your MBBS and become a doctor. You must also acquire information about the advancements or promotion prospects. That means if you're doing a particular job, how that particular job gives you the opportunities to grow in your career, and what are the economic returns, which means that if you're investing huge amount of money for doing a particular course, then what are the economic returns that you might get after doing that course. And lastly, we must know that what are the advantages and disadvantages of choosing a particular job. For example, if I choose a particular job, it would be a regular job, but the disadvantages can be, it can be a transferable job. Matching the qualities which you possess with the qualities that are required for each of the selected occupations is also very necessary. Unless you match your qualities with the selected occupation, you would not be satisfied in that particular job. It is also important that out of those three or four occupations that you have chosen, at the end you should again select the most suitable occupation for yourself. Work towards achievement of your goal of entering into the occupation. That means while planning for a particular career or while planning a career, you must always be working towards achieving your goal, whatever is required for that. You should be studying all the time, you should be doing hard work, and you should be exploring different options for yourself. It is very important for you to note that for the students, the initial step to select a career is first of all to select or to wisely select the subjects for study. I just want to add one more thing here, that in various places there are guidance and counseling centers where one can get assistance in self-appraisal and obtaining information about various occupations. You can also consult a career counselor or a career teacher if you have any difficulty while planning or building your career. The last is that what are the special provisions for career development? So, better late than never. You might have heard this a lot of times. It is a common saying which is also applicable to the field of education. Avenues for career development are available at all stages of life. Some such avenues are continuing education and in-service training. Let us understand that what are the different avenues. For example, first is continuing education. That means even if you are in a job, you had to choose that job because of any of the personal reasons and you could not finish up your studies. So, you can always keep studying while on the job. And as we discussed in the last program, that there are various open and distance learning institutions that help people to continue their education through their education while doing their job. NIOS is one such institution. In-service job trainings also helps for career development. What is in-service job training? That means when you are in a particular job, there are various trainings that your organizations gives you or provides you that helps you in honing your skills. Then is the career adjustment. That means that there are times that comes when we have to make career adjustment. Career adjustment means either we need to shift the shift from the present profile to a different profile in which we are working, or we need to shift our job, or we need to shift altogether the career option. For example, today I am working as a teacher, tomorrow I might work as an executive. So, there are different career adjustments that a person makes. For example, they can make their career adjustments after retirement, if they do not like the working environment, if there are certain health problems that a person is facing, and if a person wants to advance in the career, then also people adjust, make career adjustments. Dear learners, this was all about today's program. But before we wind up, we must know that what we could understand in the program. First of all, we tried to understand the career development. That means all the activities which a person does in his or her lifetime. These activities include the personal occupations and the social life of the person. Then we discussed that career development is overall development in the lifestyle of a person. It is always dynamic, ongoing, and a gradual process. Exploratory, establishment, maintenance, and decline are the important stages of career development. Self-appraisal, appraisal of chosen career, and matching the abilities of the person with the abilities required by the job are some of the important tips for career planning. Career adjustment is shifting one's vocational role, and sometimes it becomes inevitable because of various reasons. For example, one reason might be your health. So this was all about today's program. I hope you have understood the topic well. Thank you.